Hello, this is Richard Hayes. I'm over at Eric and Dagmar's house in Ossenbrück, an awesome place, Germany. And we've just had a couple of days where we've been preaching and teaching the Word of God, and Holy Spirit whacked a few people today as well. Just had a really good day, and the church came over from Buchenberg, so we had a day together. But we met a new friend while we're here, and I want to introduce you to Benjamin. He's been a friend of Eric and Dagmar for a long, long, long time, and they say he's a pretty good guy. He translated one of my messages today, but he got to hear a lot of the things that we're sharing and teaching over here. And so, Benjamin, I'd just like to take a moment here with you and kind of what were your opinion on what you heard while you got to be here with us these days. This is Benjamin. What's your last name?
Genter.
Genter. That's a nice name. Mm-hmm. And so you've been a Christian for many, many years.
Yeah, definitely.
And you and Eric went to Bible school together?
Yep.
Shared a flat?
Yes, we did.
Done a bunch of mission projects together?
We did, definitely, yep.
Stayed saved for how many years?
30 years.
Think you're going to make it?
For sure.
No doubt about it. Share us a little bit about what you thought or what you felt like impacted you today, while, or these days that we got to be together.
Well, actually, really, really ministered to me, because those things about righteousness and about, you know, just really living in the presence of the Lord, living in this undeserved grace and with an open heaven, those are things that I had experienced strongly since I came from a total atheist background.
Oh, wow.
Plunged into real life. You know, I didn't have this, you know, this religious stuff to work through and everything. I just plunged from zero full into New Testament life. So I really know what this is about. But in the past, through whatever circumstances and things, I did lose some of that reality. So this really greatly challenged me and refreshed my heart to really, really plunge into that again and throw all the religious replacement stuff that the devil has to offer on his palate, throw all this religious replacement stuff out of my heart completely, you know, and invite the Holy Spirit to expand the reality that I already know in my heart.
Wow.
So it's very, very refreshing.
Can you think of any specific type thought or verse that kind of reached out and grabbed a hold of you while during the teaching session in these days?
Not particularly, but, you know, kind of experientially. You know, what I felt in my heart, again, really opened deep fountains in my own spirit.
Oh, wow.
That are there, but that were kind of a little bit covered over. Especially this experience of Jesus, they said, you know, this is where the Father said, this is my beloved Son in whom I am well pleased. This is for me not just a verse, it's been an experience, because the Holy Spirit got this into my system, and it just causes a happiness and a joy that is heavenly.
Fantastic.
No copyright on earth for that.
Amen.
You know.
Well, as I mentioned, we're here in the house of Eric and the beautiful Dagmar. Dagmar, what's your opinion of kind of what we've got to experience these few days we've been together?
It was really heaven on earth. It was really blessing us, because it was encouraging us to go further with this message, not only for us in Osnabrück, but for Germany and for other countries. And we really want to bring this message even to Uganda, to Africa, or other nations.
Now, I understand you guys, you and Eric, have made a couple of trips to Uganda already preaching and teaching.
Yes, we did.
How did that go?
This was really, really good. I think we really could change a church a little bit. Yeah, so if we taught in one church for 1 week, and it was amazing how people get changed. Their faces started to shine. They started to understand deep things of righteousness they never understood before like this. And they started to get miracles in their lives happening even by this simple teaching of
righteousness. Isn't that fantastic?
Yes.
What kind of feedback were we getting from the people these last 2 days? Opinions and comments?
Yes, it's since, like Benjamin said, it's a new thing. Thing is starting in their hearts, a new hope or a new life, how you can you say, is starting in them, and they really start, they get the understanding, I'm righteous, I'm like Jesus, and now I start to act on it. I'm not only hearing this, but I start and be this person who is like Jesus, and I will tell my neighbors, I will tell my colleagues, and I will change the world.
Fantastic. We don't want to leave Eric out of this. So, Eric, what's your kind of opinion? We've had a couple of good days together, had some good worship time, without a doubt. Presence of God, I know I was on the floor for who knows how long. But kind of what's your feelings on what you've seen the people taking in these last couple of days?
Yeah. First for me, or the time for the church, it was again spiritual diving time.
Okay.
And what you say, when it's go deeper, when you have more stuff, when you have more revelation, it's going easier. And this is what I can see, this is what I can feel, that the church are now on a point, it will be going easier to live by faith, to reach the city, to heal the sick. And this is fantastic. It's a simple concept, but this weekend we dive very deep in this very easy, fantastic concept of the free gift of righteousness.
Excellent. I really appreciate getting to spend time here with everybody. And I think the little saying that we say would kind of sum this up: the deeper you get in, the simpler it gets. And I know that's true, because a lot of the people here have got to be in a lot of the meetings that we've had in Germany throughout the years. And many have been in Master Builder, and several have been in Foundations. But even so, as we just kind of come and the Holy Spirit begins to open up the scriptures again, you just see them. The deeper you get in, the simpler it gets. And it just begins to come out of their hearts, some powerful lifestyle. Well, you know, I'm Richard Hayes, and I'm over here in Germany one more time. And you can communicate with me through this website, obviously. But also, I answer every email that comes to me from Richard or at cciworld.org. So give me a comment, give me a thought, and let me know how you're enjoying these videos. Bless you.